Thank you. We are really privileged and honored to have amongst us our chief guest, a very, very humble personality. He can be compared to a fruit laden tree, very down to earth and grounded. When I got the opportunity to invite him to the school for this function, I had requested him for his profile. And just listen to what he said. He said, "Ma'am, I have nothing to speak about myself. I have spent my whole life teaching." This very sentence has a depth of an ocean. Because he was focused only on teaching and he has created many geniuses like we all. So, hats off to him. He is none other than Dr. Tapan Patnaik, professor in English. He is retired, but he is the store of some knowledge. Next, we have our Honorable Chairman Sri Raghunath Mishra, esteemed manager Sri Pratap Kumar Jena, all the members of the dais from school managing committee, Vice Principal Sri Sarveshwar Samar, Administrative Supervisor Mrs. Anusha Patel, all my dear students and my dear colleagues, and the parents who are sitting in other rooms and watching you live. Subhashri ma'am is doing that. So don't worry, your parents are watching you. The teachers or those who are not present in this room also, they are also watching you. So once again, my heartiest congratulations to all of you. This is a day for celebration, though it's a bit late, but certain things were not within our control. It is only the Almighty who has decided this day. So let us accept it as a grand day and start the function. You have seen what the teachers have sung for you and as well as a guest. So everything that is happening with you today, you should be thankful to the Almighty. Because without His blessings, whatever effort you have given in your studies would not have come to this stage, what you are achieving today. Similarly, your thankfulness also should go to your parents. We always speak about parents, we forget about grandparents and your siblings and other family members who are there. Because every time your parents have asked your younger or elder brother or sister to switch off the TV, not to make noise, because they want you to study. That is their contribution for you, to create a conducive environment where you can read and write and excel in your exam. Similarly, when you come to your teachers, don't forget the teachers who have taught you in lower classes. The primary foundation, what your teachers have given you, do not forget them. Be thankful to each and every individual of this school because they have created an environment where you can read well. All the members of the school managing committee, everyone needs your thankfulness. You should be learning something from our guest today, the humbleness. You have achieved a lot and you will achieve more. But this success will not have its meaning if you are not thankful and humble. That should be there with you, because achieving success is definitely your hard work. You have gained something, but retaining it and being a very good individual is more important than scoring the marks. So you need to be a very good individual in your life. For that, you have to be grounded. Don't take the pride into your head. Don't forget your roots. They are your parents, your grandparents, your family, your teachers, wherever you go. Your teacher's blessings, your parents' blessings, your grandparents' blessings are there with you. So never forget them. With that, I will come to the end, saying that always be thankful to God for what you have got today. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.
For your wonderful and kind words. It's very important to stay grounded. It is true. I would now request our manager sir to share his thoughts.
you, ma'am. Good afternoon, dear friends. It came to Chairman Sri Ramnath Mishra. It came to hear Dr. Akon Patnaik, Madam Principal, Head Principal, some members of the school management, your teachers, and the assault is a curious opinion. We are running one year there. No. Yes, we are very certain. The assault of children should be. Usually, we organize some children just after the request of the result. But you know the things to be taken to the anger. And we went on calculating this month, or next month, that this month in the year 2021. So, too late, we decided not to miss it. But you know, if you dare to miss this opportunity, you'll miss it nicer. There are few opportunities to see in our house, in the year of the year. And nothing can better than what type of we wanted to finish the team on this occasion, that he was supposed to be back. And as Madam Principal said, in making you achieve this, role of teachers is very important, role of parents, you know, so many nights you must have spent touching you in the study. So, not to get into them, because I'm prepared. And never think your young growth life. It starts. Life starts, career starts after practice. You have to do the right time. There will be pressure from the peer group. Pressure from parents, meeting, do this, work, go in this field. You select, do this line. But whatever line you make, but in our day, that very urgently. Beginning the line is very, very limited. But now it is very fast speaking carefully. Whatever line you make, not necessarily political engineering or medical or humanities, whichever line you make, but first of all, I offer to all to be a good human being. Vijayan school, a different school, you know. It's the only school run by Vijayan to society, government school. They never run after profiteering. No profiteering working with them. No business finding them. Only auto is for the society. And disseminate knowledge, provide quality education, create quality education in the society. And like government, Mr. Ambedkar, the Prime Minister, is still struggling. Nothing that he has no objective, no aim for himself. Only aim is for the society. And that cannot be better area than education. It wants for the society. So I have always been proud of the DNA, with the one or two. What is one to see that your behavior conducts the results? That is perspective, yes, there is a beginning. There is a beginning. That's always something, some discipline, character, quality, visible in very clearly in you, so that you can depend on yourself. Society now is good human beings, not brilliant human beings. They are brilliant, there are so many. Millions is there, everything is there, but we are very much in need of to become effective. So kindly, my appeal to all of you, you have been brought up in a different atmosphere, so here you have got new teachers, the principals have got new parents, they are all fortunate, all fortunate. So now we know from your partner, when you apply very responsible positions, never forget the school, never forget the society. Not to be the best of society, that is why you get to the school. With this, I congratulate all of you. You are the achievers, you are the glorious achievers of the school. We are always very proud of you. So, with this, I wish you very bright and glorious career ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now it's time for our valedictorians to share their wonderful journey. Success.
success stories are something which even today everybody would like to hear. Yes, I agree that Rome was not built in a day. So kindly, our valedictorians, please share your secret on how you achieved your success. So please welcome our first valedictorian, Standard 12 Science Topper, Aditya Ranjan Das, for Session 2019 and 20. Please come and share your thought drive.
I am Aditya, feeling so privileged and proud, so privileged and happy to be back to my school today. I'm standing over here to thank all of those people who have made it possible for me to feel the taste of the feeling of getting me into the ladder of the success. So it all started on the day when I stood first in my entire school and got an aggregate of 95% in my class 12 board examination of 2020. I received a lot of warm wishes from my teachers, my parents, my family and my all dear friends. It was a very joyous and happy moment for me. But more of that, I felt this little bit of achievement can make me feel so good and addicted at the same time. So what it would feel like when I realize my own dreams and work hard enough to achieve it. So it makes me feel so ecstatic to think about that thing, that I also hope that in the near future I make my school, my parents, my teachers and all of my dear friends proud enough for me again. And also I congratulate all those, my friends, my juniors, everyone who is sitting over here for their success, and also for creating a benchmark for their juniors who I also able to carry upon. At last, I would also like to add something which I have learned from my new mentor, my teacher, Dr. Subhashri Das, that there will be moments in your life when you don't achieve anything, or you don't achieve what you are longing for, or you don't achieve what you want to do. People will be there around you, pointing out questions on your capabilities. At that time, you shouldn't be beating upon your loss. Rather, you should gather up all your courage and get up and make sure that the time comes in your life that those people who are questioning upon you should cite an example to others you come back to see them greater than you said that. So with this, thank you, and all the best to my dear friends and juniors for the future. Thank you.
Now I welcome Standard 10 Topper for the year 2019 and 20, Swatika Rao.
I passed out from this school in class 10, and I'm very happy that I passed with nice results, and I'm very thankful to all my teachers for the support and for teaching so nicely. Like, I was able to improve so much in the last 4 years of this school. But there were days that I felt really anxious about my result, but at the end I want to thank all my teachers and my parents and my family members to advise me and motivate me so that I can beat my anxiety and keep up with the work and get good results. Thank you.
Respected Chairman Sir, Shri Raghunath Mishra, address the gathering, please.
Respected principal, Pritha Das. Respected members of the managing committee who are present today, and I should say my dear students, we are extremely happy to meet you again after so many days. As you know, for reasons which are beyond our control. Anyway, good times have arrived, and I am too happy to tell you that we should begin your work in right earnest so that our school will prosper, you will prosper, and your parents will be proud of. It's a very significant day for you because you have crossed 2 milestones, class 10, and also class 12. Life will be thereafter, why should I say, life will be, because sometime you will be 21 and you will be a part of people, we the people of India, and to which so much respect is given in our Indian constitution. That is why I say that you will serve your country, serve your motherland, serve your town, serve your village, and wherever you are in the world, have service, humanity in your mind. My request to you is always remember that you should respect women, religion, and also your parents, so that they will teach you how to be a good man. And above all, your alma mater and also your teachers attend you. Never forget your school, never forget your classmates, never forget your association with the school and association with all around you. Now, wherever you are, you should devote time and attention to the society and always try to be good citizens, because it is now enough to read more than more, to be a good student or a studious student, but at the same time you should be a human being first. As you know, our Gita, Ramayana, Mahabharata, all combined together, and the essence of every Puranas and every scripture are in the Constitution. So try to read the Constitution so that will only show you how to live peacefully in India, in the whole of the world. You have studied well, got proud pride to our school, and you have done excellent. Your achievement is really excellent, and we are all proud of you. The whole city is proud of you now, because you have elevated the standard of our school to a certain height, which He paid many penalties for us. That is why on this very happy occasion, I pay my respects to your parents, Dr. Rai, so well to make you a good student, an ideal student, a studious student, and above all, a very hard-working person. Your teachers are excellent. They have done wonderful work in this pandemic period, both offline and online. And I congratulate everybody, every teacher, individually, that the contribution that they have made during this difficult period. You have also gone through, you have isolated at home, and you encountered so many difficulties, but in spite of that, you have survived, and you survived, and also have enough experience to serve this society. I will again request you to be a good human being and serve the society well. Thank you, gentlemen. I request, I pray to God that you will rise higher and higher and be a good citizen of India. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
On your success and wish you and my great success for your future lifetime. I wanted to say a few lines regarding our secret, the Tapan Kanti Mohanji, the Tapan Kanti Mohanji, because I was today in 1980. He is such a good teacher. You have not been in this place, so you can't believe. He's been doing words and his power of expression. It will transport you to different areas like sometimes Shakespeare time, sometimes historian time, or sometimes yes, yes time. Every place in his class, different place. So I also love him very much. Because of this internet venture, he is coming to the school. I saw him. Then I realized that nobody knows about him. But I have experienced what is his quality. So I want to say two things about him. And my best wishes and my only advice to the student is don't be after selfish. Or self-centered or equal. If you remain humble and try to learn from every situation, from every moment, then the life will, the whole world will be like a family. And this again is to that the different types of people will subside somehow or other. And you are the future of the whole world, so on your shoulder lies a future world.
And they have not only given a lot of to our teachers community, everyone. Respected dignitaries on the dais, respected principal ma'am, all my colleagues and my dear students. As you know, it is the time where we are meeting after a long pandemic situation, and you all are now the flying birds, where you will be excelling in a flying colors. So all of you, I was rushing after hearing the name, so that's why it is, as you know, the respiration problem. So that is the function is going on, so that is why. So as you know that you all are nine the flying birds, so you will be excelling in the flying colors. So I wish you all should excel and make the name of the BGM's one and BGM's two also. All are studying in BGM 1 also and BGM 2 also. I have heard many of the students are also there. So you should keep our name of the BGMs, okay? And you should be a good citizen. That only I will say. All of you, God bless you. Thank you.
Dr. Tapan Patnaik, speak a few words, please.
Training your class. Vice Principal, Sri Sarveshwari. I am very happy. You have been allowed to sit down and speak to the students. Of course, I am told that the parents are sitting elsewhere and they will be getting a view through a screen of what's going on here. So I must also address the parents, the fortunate parents of this talented collection of young ladies and gentlemen. It's not for nothing that I address you as young ladies and gentlemen, because I expect you to grow up into wonderful young ladies and gentlemen, because you have passed a year ago and you already are on the way to join civilian life and make the life of this country richer by your contribution. We are all gathered here. Of course, you have to accept me, because I am a rank outsider. All the others here that have gathered this afternoon, which is developing into a wonderful evening, to felicitate you, have a stake in your success. Although I am an outsider, a neutral nobody, I too have a stake in you, because you, I'm sure, and the likes of you that come out through the schools of our great motherland are really fortunate, because you have been given, or you have the chance to avail yourself of facilities that most youngsters of the country do not. Therefore, you have a lot to be thankful about, and you must thank your teachers. I've joined all the dignitaries and your teachers and your parents in applauding your success, because I believe that your success will contribute to the general success of our great country. But remember, success comes with a price. Success brings along with it a certain responsibility. Responsibility to your less capable friends and peers towards whom you must be very generous and share your success with them, share your ideas, share your understanding of different subjects with your peers. You have a responsibility towards your parents. You have a responsibility towards your teachers who have selflessly given you so much. And of course, when I applaud you and your success, I, by extension, also applaud the amount of hard work that the teachers have put behind you all in trying to make you successful. Well, someone called William Shakespeare said that brevity is the soul of wit. I shall be brief because a teacher finds it very difficult to be brief. Right? When a teacher begins to harangue, well, it's an endless speech, right? 40 minutes, the length of your class, right? So that's it, I'll try to be brief. But I have to, today there has been an enormity, too much of stress on the fact that we should all grow up into good human beings. Almost every one of my peers here has insisted upon that. The fact that you must become good human beings. You might get any laurel in your education or in your life, in your jobs, but being a good human being ultimately supports, buttresses the country. The country needs good human beings. The very same gentleman that I just referred to, called William Shakespeare, also said, humility is endless. The word endless is a little baffling. Humility, to be humble, is endless. Means it is without any purpose. You are not going to be humble with an objective, with an ulterior motive. But humility should become your character. Humility should become you. You should be the very picture of humility wherever you go, because that alone will enable you to receive the grace and the blessings of destiny, the Almighty, and this vast universe of ours. As you all know, that the universe is a living and organic thing. It's an organism, you can say. It has an organicism of its own. The universe is constantly changing, constantly mutating, right? Like the SARS-CoV virus, right? Which has mutated into COVID-19, right? So that's it. The universe keeps on mutating, changing. And scientists tell us that the universe is constantly expanding too. Therefore, it is changing and constantly mutating and transient and expanding universe. You, like everybody else, will be facing a lot of challenges. COVID-19 itself is a big challenge, and we are facing it. These challenges cannot be avoided. Remember, COVID-19 is not going to go away. It's going to stay. So mankind has to find ways to live and adapt itself to fight this virus and not be adversely affected by it. Likewise, life is full of challenges. But challenges have a strange organism of their own. Even challenges are not static, they are organic. Challenges make you think of alternatives. Challenges bring, in other words, opportunities. So you, the talented lot here, a collective of talented youngsters, young ladies and gentlemen that I just referred to, you should be prepared for the challenges as well as the opportunities that these challenges may afford, and you must find ways to surmount these challenges. I promise that I'm going to be brief, And therefore, I think I should rest here. I should bring upon you whatever blessings that I can invoke in the universe to bless you, to make your lives worthwhile, and to let you contribute to society in which you live, because this is a society which needs your contribution. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your motivational, thoughtful and impactful words. Unfortunately, I was never your student, but fortunately, I got to hear you today and I did pick up a lot of positive pieces. Thank you. Now I would request teachers, Mrs. Monalisa Prayaraj, TGT English, and Dr. Subhashree Das, TGT English, to take over for the next segment of today's program.
It's now time to call upon those students who have brought flowers to our school. I start with Swagatika Raut, who has talked.
Please come up to the dais. Anushka,
over the eyes. Thank you.
She won the lecture at the class level and received a cash prize of rupees 10,000 and became a third level participant. Huge round of applause to her, she was among the top 60 national awardees at national level exhibition. She participated in Fine Festival of Innovation and Entrepreneurship at Gujarat and is privileged to interact with the Honorable President of India, Excellency Ramnath Kovind. Subsequently, she presented to the school at national level to do the science exhibition, and she also participated in art and was selected for Ireland's National Fair of Bangalore. And all the credit goes to her parents and the project made and designed by Vijayji, Biology Modelist of Das Ma'am, and her team and the science staff. All the credit goes to her. The award is instituted by our manager, Sir Shri Pratap Kumar Jain, in memorial of his parents, Salabala Jogendra Memorial Award, which goes to her Science Scientist Innovation Award. She is also receiving a cash prize of 2,000. Running shield and a trophy. That's all for Patya Sandra. You are really great proud to our teacher. And all the team in her mind and in her pleasure and in her project. Thank you all.
Senior members of the school SLC of the dais. The grooming birds, my dear loving students, parents who are witnessing through this live webinar. It's a privilege that we have been addressed by the grand teacher and to be witnessed by the grand students. So as sir was referring and here some of the teachers also referred that we are truly grateful sir from your hectic schedule and tight schedule you've been here to address with your valuable words and encouraging words. We are ever thankful to you. My heartfelt thanks also goes to esteemed chairman sir and manager sir, because as you know that as everybody was referring that human, we all have to be good human beings. And we are fortunate that we are working in such a profession that we are producing these human beings, I mean to say that human resources. Whatever demands are there in the market, it is produced by this same institution and is very much guided by these esteemed chairman sir, manager sir and the members who are sitting in front of the guys. So we are really thankful to the whole management for guiding us time and again. I also give my heartfelt gratitude to the parents particularly, because it is their sincere effort because of which we have been able to assemble here. So your success is directly or indirectly reflects our, or I mean to say that all stakeholders' effort. So I should not forget to thank all the teachers. As you know, the teaching is such a serious profession, we have to leave all our worries behind. I truly give all my heartfelt credit to all my teaching staff members, starting from lower nursery, the mother teachers till the teachers who are teaching standard 12. Credit goes to all the whole teachers faculty. And I must not forget also to thank this set of collection of students, successful students, because of whom we are feeling proud and privileged to assemble here. I will only wish that this is just the beginning. And I will be happy on behalf of the Vijay fraternity when we will be sitting in the lobby to get an appointment from you. Because you are the true talents and you are the successful citizen, and I just want to see at the height of success. Thank you all for witnessing this event. Thank you.
In our esteemed school, to build this felicitation ceremony for Standard 10 and 12 for the session 2020-2021. On this note, I, Zampana Anand, TGTCSPD, on behalf of Paksi Jagabandhu English Medium School 2, welcome our Honorable Chief Guest Sir, Dr. Tapan Patnaik, Professor in English. He is an eminent personality in the field of teaching. He has taught in various esteemed institutions like BJB College, Ravenshaw College, Puri College. He retired from BJB College in the year 2009. He is the most humble and down-to-earth personality we have ever come across. I further take the privilege to also welcome our esteemed Chairman Sir, Shri Raghunath Mishra, Revered Manager Sir, Shri Pratap Kumar Jena, Senior SMC members, Principal Mrs. Kanika Das, Vice Principal Sir, Mr. Sapreshwar Samal, Administrative Supervisor, Mrs. Anusuya Pothal, all the teachers, administrative faculty members, parents, and my very dear galaxy of intellectuals, art students who has made us extremely proud. Welcome everyone. I would request our teachers to offer a token of love to the blooming buds in the form of flowers. Now I would like to request our very dear Kanchan ma'am and her team to present the welcome song.
Thank you.
Christ. So, my happiest congratulations to you all. You are the pride of the school. You have made the school very, very proud with your excellent marks. Your hard work has taken the true color. Today, in this auspicious moment and a joyous moment, I thank the Almighty on your behalf, because whatever you have done, it has made us proud. The entire school is proud for you. So you also feel thankful to the Almighty and your second God. They are your parents. When I say parents, it includes your grandparents, your parents, as well as all other members in your family, because each of them has contributed in their own way to create an environment for you to study. So your thankfulness should go to them, because their slightest sacrifice has given you an opportunity to come to this extent. Examples are many. Then next is your second teacher. That is your teachers who taught you not only in the class that you last passed, but I am referring to all those from the primary level till standard 12, whoever has made your journey in this school successful, be thankful to them. Because they have made you read and write, holding your hand, the primary teacher. Don't forget them. And I'm not talking about today only. This is just the beginning. Your success has started. And in future, you will step many more steps of success. Every moment, don't forget your parents, your grandparents, your teachers, your friends, whoever has contributed in your life. Because you are working very hard and you have got your result. Whatever work you have done, the hard work that you have done, without that 1% of blessings from anyone, be it God, be it the elders, be it your friends, anyone who has wished you good luck, it comes from the heart. And if it is not there throughout your life will become meaningless. That is what I believe. So never forget what others have done for you throughout your life. Be thankful to everyone. In that process, you become a very good individual, because that is what your parents want, that is what your teachers want. Being a good individual is more important than scoring a big position in life, or holding a good position, or scoring good marks, or doing anything great in your life. Being a good individual is much more important than anything else in this world. Thank you so much for listening to me. Time is short. May God bless you. We are proud of you. Thank you.
He said, at the moment need of the hour is, we need to be good humans first. Now I request our very respected manager, sir, to share his thoughts.
Taking us back, 15 years back.
the fact landed in the pool. The parent holding your finger, you crying, but I not go to the pool, not go to the park. And after entering the park, and there was somebody, like teacher, putting in the park, taking care of you, sharing their love, affection, and care, and making you grow up. And today, you are this very important phase of your life. In your life journey, you have reached a very important day today. But this day, the teacher and the parent have waited so eagerly, so anxiously. My child going to school, studying in school to class. And after the class came, he will be young and will come out with colors, flying colors. And I will definitely enjoy this moment. This moment, we are 14 years in front of 15 years in front of that. So in getting this process, your perseverance, your continuous effort is one part. The teacher's care, love and teaching is another part. Parents are also done enough. The parents have seen, they say, sir, we never switch on the television. So if we switch on, it may distract the child, it may draw their attention. So we also decided not to watch the TV for 1 year when the child is in class pain and pain. See, the sudden sacrifice the parents are prepared to do and they do practically. So, you are at the age, but you know nothing about it. Already grown up, you have done so many things, studying in the school, studying from the books. So, when you decide the next course of action, you must have read the poem, Road Not Taken, in past days. So, think judiciously. There will be pressure, there will be pressure from the friends, relatives, go this line, that line, but you have to do the right line. You ask your own intuition, for your own conscience. Always keep your own strength and weakness within you, in you. And keeping that in view, your strength and weakness, you choose your life. Never be pressurized, never accept what the parents say. You accept what the conscience says and your strength and weakness says. Okay? So, I can tell you this much. The DGM school, you know, so it was started in the year 2006. In 2006, the school was started. And in the first batch, after 2016, madam, 2016, the first batch started. And it carried a unique record, perhaps no other school might be was carrying. 56 appeared, started. 19 got A grade, 19. All got 60% above. All got 60% above. 19 got grade A. Certificate 39% above. So this unique record, no other school might be having again. So this has all been possible because of teachers, whether it is teachers of nursery classes or secondary or high secondary. And after that, we have never stopped. We have always seen you, the students, marching iron and iron. Every year the number is getting multiplied. The number is increasing day by day. So I congratulate all of you. And as students of Vision School, whether it is one or two, we always keep different weigh and measure the merit in a different angle. We always not see 30% of our position, but we also see what the quality you possess, what character you build within, and what is your human value that you carry. Because I know at this moment, we have plenty of brilliant people. In the society, we see plenty of brilliant people. Brilliant in this line, that line, education, computer. But we are very much lacking in one area, that is human value. Human value. we pass out from the school, we forget the school. We forget the teacher. We never develop that sort of emotional attachment. Or we, you know, we celebrate Mother's Day, Father's Day. Then where from this concept of Gurudev Vamsha? If we celebrate Mother's Day, Father's Day, this concept came from where? Gurudev Vamsha. So when you become a complete human being, you have to carry so many values, not only in the academy, so many values. Then only, wherever you be, if you turn the page of the newspaper and see where they begin, the signs will definitely be covered. We must wait for that day, once that all of you should give in a different way in the society. Because Vijayan school is culturally different. So it is never a public making school. All of you are perfect. Like other schools, they do join the school for the purpose of profit, business. Here there is no proprietorship, no one man rule business. The society is comprising so many people like Sri Ramnath Mishra, there are 25, there are so many. Out of 100 member society, out of 70 will be 75. Data professors, bureaucrats, professionals like that. Then only motto is to see that both the schools, Vijayan School 1 and 2, grow day by day, provide quality education, and students get benefit of that. No profit like it, nothing, no profit like it. So, we definitely should be happy when we see that someday somebody, someone to sign. We definitely feel that the time we spend here has not gone waste. It was meaningful. It was meaningful. The time we spend here with you was meaningful. We definitely feel that. So, all the way, whether you are inside the campus or anywhere else, even without seeing the faces, always blessings flow from here. That would always be there. And respect your parents, teachers, never forget the school. When you grow up, occupy responsible positions. Always keep a take a promise that you have to pay back to the school, which gives you the quality that you have. And you are fortunate, very, very fortunate. You compare yourselves. You should always be proud of the parents that are choosing Vijayan School as a center of education, as your center of education. There are so many children deprived of quality education. Education even, not at quality. But you are so fortunate, you have got the benefit of availing quality education in Vijayan School, thanks to your parents. That is possible because of parents only. So, on this day, I congratulate the achievers, last day, and good. And pray God, you improve, you grow day by day, be good human beings and make us stronger. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. That was really captivating and inspiring. And for the small, comprehensive report that sir gave in a nutshell. And today's pick-up line was, go with your instincts as much as you can for the success. Now it's time for the valedictorians to share their wonderful journey. It's your time. I do agree that Rome was not built in a day. So kindly, our valedictorians, please share your secret on how you achieved your success. You know, success stories, whether it is small or big, it always inspires everyone. So please welcome our first valedictorian of the day, Standard 12 Science Proper, Tanmay Kumar Acharya, for the session 2021. Please come and share your thoughts.
Good evening, everyone. Respected principal ma'am, respected chief guest, esteemed chairman sir, manager sir, vice principal sir, my respected teachers and my dear friends. First of all, I would like to congratulate all the achievers who are over here who scored such a brilliant marks at their examinations. I truly believe that the way to success is only hard work and your self-belief. But I would like to add just a pinch to it that hard work only doesn't make the sense. Hard work in a correct direction and a perfect way makes a change. Because always it's quite known that only the proper orientations makes the reactions of the products. That is why the hard work is to be done in a proper way, in a proper manner, which we all have must have done. That is why we are actually over here. If I will, before 2 years when I joined the plus 2 way, I was here from class 6, but when I joined the plus 2 way 2 years back, I have never thought that I will be standing over here in front of you, sharing my views and my experience, which I have learned from the last 2 years. But when I'm standing over here today, I'm actually lots of words to say.
Thank you, my dear Tanmay. May God bless you immensely. You spoke very well, long way to go. Now I welcome Standard 12 Commerce Topper Suman Dixit for the session 2021.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Suman Dixit of Class 12 Commerce. Actually, I don't know where to start. Like, there's so many memories, so many things I want to say, but I will make it short and quick. 12 years. 12 years of long journey. 12 years worth memory. That's how long I have been in this school. And I would say that I have never dreamt of this moment. I have always kept going on and on in this school. The school has been, I have been attached to this school for so long, and now that I am letting go of it, it's kind of hard. How do you move on from such important piece of your life to another one? I still wonder how long this journey has become. How suddenly did it end? I still remember in class 11, I used to discuss with my friends about what we would do to make our last year of school memorable. Of course, studying is included. And along with studying, we thought about many long ways to make our last year of schooling life memorable. We had so many reasons we thought of. And we planned so much, but all these dreams, all these plannings went in vain last year at launch. We were disappointed, I was disappointed. Online classes were met thanks to our school for making it happen. Studying was not exactly my first priority at that time. I was so down and I was feeling so helpless. My plans were crushed, my dreams were crushed. And then came my teachers, my friends too. But I would like to thank my friends, all of my friends, all of my teachers. I contacted them and I still remember how nervous I was when I texted them. I couldn't call them. I was so down. And the response I got from all of my teachers, I can't explain it. They were so understandable. They helped me so much. They let me take a few days to get myself up and then I again joined. They encouraged me. That was the moment when, you know how they say that teachers are your backbone in educational career? They are. They truly are.
I, even saying this, I'm getting so emotional because mental health is something we all go through in this time, and we want, we expect support from both our parents and our teachers, and I'm so glad that my teachers helped me. Thank you, teachers. Also, thanks to my teachers who have been with me since class 1 to 10. They have a very big part in making me who I am. All the journey, I remember, I also had this kind of moment when I was in 10. And my class teacher at that time, she helped me a lot in that. My teachers, what I want to say is, my teachers have helped me, supported me, and encouraged me at every up and down of my life. I have memories of this school from as long as I remember. It's so long. It's 12 years. Can you imagine? I have been in this place for 12 years and suddenly it's coming to my mind. I still can't grasp the fact that I have to let it all go. So I'm still trying to get myself together because of course I have to start another phase of my life. But this school will always be will always have a very special moment, special place in my life. Thank you everyone, thank you my friends, Almeida. Thank you everyone I have met in the school. Thank you to all my teachers, thank you this school.
For the year 2020-2021, Deeksha Dev, please come and share your thoughts.
You can get success
Only when those small efforts are not stopped and your perseverance is not put a full stop, which you all have done. I remember the lesson, his first flight. I hope all my students remember that. The young seagull who was hesitant in flying and taking his first flight. You all have taken your first flight and I congratulate you for that, for getting success, for being successful and achieving what you have achieved today. But there is a lot more to achieve, lot more. The full sky is there in front of you and you have to do that. We are standing here to see you soar high in the sky and making us proud of you. I have already told my students several times, I would like to see all of you back here after 10 years, 15 years, telling that, madam, I have achieved what I wanted to achieve. No matter what you want to achieve, I am sure you will achieve that. All the best. Fly higher and higher, and there should not be a limit. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Manalisa, ma'am, for your wonderful words. May I now welcome Swayamprabha, ma'am, PGT English, to speak a few words, please.
Good evening, everyone. Esteemed dignitaries on the dais, my respected colleagues, and my lovely students. First of all, I would like to convey a heartfelt congratulations to all of you for achieving the dreams, whatever we all have dreamt together. Then would like to wish good luck for your future adventures, though I don't believe in luck, because I believe everything depends on the intensity of your hard work. So what you put into, you will definitely get back. So do your job with utmost sincerity and do the hard work, then sit back, relax to relish the fruit of success. So next, I won't take much of your time as I am running short of words to say you something in front of the person from whom I have learned everything. What I am right now, this person inspired me. Sir, Dr. Tapan Patnaik, sir, I was your student. I know I am nobody to be remembered. But sir, you are the person I admired in my entire life. Though I didn't get much of time to spend with you, I regret each and every moment of life. Seriously, sir. Yes, sir, you inspired me to be a teacher. Truly, and each and every moment you left, after you left the college, I used to miss you each and every day. I used to wait along and used to think, why, sir, why did you leave? 2009, sir, you got retired, and that is the year when I joined BJB Autonomous College. And sir, I remember the day you taught us to his point stress, and that was by Andrew Harvey. And sir, the each and every word made that poem so marvelous. And sir, that day, during those days, I couldn't say, I couldn't admire you, I couldn't even speak in front of you. But today I want to say, sir, I used to praise you and I used to say every detail about you and your teaching to my father. He belonged to the same profession, that is why he used to feel that excitement. Like right now I am, like I feel I am in my college days, and I have once again. So I think my students are fortunate enough to hear something from you, sir. Like, who has built me, who has met me, what I am. And they right now are getting a chance to hear from you, sir. Thank you, sir, and thank you, BJ Stu, for giving me this chance and to be a part of this evening. And once again, all the best, my dear students, and good luck for your future endeavors. Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful words. It is true that whatever you believe, whatever you throw to the universe, it will gravitate back to you. It is an honor and privilege to welcome respected Chairman Sir Shri Ramnath Mishra to address the gathering. Should I give you the mic?
Very good afternoon to all of you. Special tribute to chief guest who just had the student teacher relationship so wonderfully explained by the guest speaker. She was really grateful for all that has been done to her. That is why I know that Mr. Patnaik belongs to a very noble profession. We admire the also enemy at night. Respected Chief Guest, respected Manager, Madam Principal, respected members of the Managing Committee, most respected parents who are waiting outside, and above all my dear students who have done so very well in the two examinations which are sitting in the night. Their class 11 and class 12. We are very fortunate to be in this school for the last 12 years, and we have had whatever is possible for you by your sheer determination, labor, and hard work. You know, success comes before hard work. In a place like this dictionary, in dictionary, success comes first, but followed by hard work. Hard work means followed by work. So, dear students, you have done very well and somehow very successfully. We give pride to the institution that you study and so on. I congratulate you heartily, all of you, to all your teachers, to all your mentors, to both who are associated with this August institution. As you know, this August institution has been built brick by brick by no other person than Pratap Kumar Jadhav, the manager of the school, and he is devoting 24/7 every day into black hands. So I must congratulate him for the wonderful work he is doing in every sphere in all these schools, and particularly in this school, and he is devoting much of his time to bring out all around. On this happy occasion, I will only tell you that you already remember that hard work never comes for nothing. It has to be at least, as the American missionary said, I have come to this world of once, any good thing that I can do, and any kindness that I can show to any human being, let me do it now, let me not get another negative, but tomorrow I shall not come any. So you should remember that as a human being, you have to show kindness to everybody. You have to show hard work, example to everybody. And then remember one thing, that whatever you may be, but you should be down to your target. You should remember that power is decorous, popularity is accidental, riches take wings. The only thing that survives is individual character. So I request you, wherever you are, you please remember this school. Please remember your teachers. Please remember the surroundings and the environment of this institution and try to improve. Try to contribute your mind to this school so that it grows and strengthens. This much I can say today. God bless you all. You rise higher and higher and higher. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Dr. Tapan Patnaik, to speak few words, please.
Good evening, everyone. Esteemed Chairman, Shri Raghunathkrishna, Manager and Mentor of the School, Shri Dattakumandana, Madam Principal, Kanika Das, Vice Principal, Shri Sarveshwar, eager and proud parents waiting outside and watching us live somewhere from the land. Trustees of the school, illustrious students and their very illustrious teachers. First of all, I must express my gratitude for being allowed to sit and speak. Forgive me my doubts and my rheumatism. I cannot stand for a long time. So they have been generous, my peers have been generous enough to allow me to speak from the chair. So forgive me yet again. Now, young ladies and gentlemen, that's how I addressed your elders, your seniors, who were felicitated a while ago. And I have a very selfish intention in calling you young ladies and gentlemen, because that is what I expect you to become. I want you, I hope you understand the difference between a woman and a lady, right? A woman and a lady, a man and a gentleman, right? That's a strange language. English is a strange language, right? Very polite language. And it's so unlike our language that we often slip and fall. It's a very treacherous language also, right? So don't misunderstand me when I address you as ladies and gentlemen, because that is what I expect you to become. You have crossed a very important milestone of your lives with flying colors. And now you are well on your way to join the mainstream of civilian life in this country. And what have you? You have a certificate in hand that tells the world that you are inordinately intelligent and talented. Therefore, this society is full of expectations from you. Remember, every individual's life is entangled, inextricably entangled with this society. If the society collapses, where goes your brilliance? It comes to naught. It becomes meaningless, isn't it? And there are so many obstacles, impediments, allurements in life, in society particularly, isn't it? Particularly in our society. I'm sure half of you can recognize the photograph of Dawood Ibrahim, a criminal, right? We often hear names, say, Harshad Mehta, who swindled the country and its financial organizations, is hyped as some kind of a financial wizard, somebody who knew how to manipulate the money market, right? After he was accused and even convicted, he was invited by university economics departments, management departments to go and address. I think that's the wrong thing to do. Evil is always more attractive than good. Remember that. I'm reminded of the sentence. I'm almost tempted to quote a line from a very famous poet, modern poet. It's a modern poet. listens. Youth is cruel and has no remorse. Remorse means repentance. Youth is cruel and has no remorse and smiles at situations which it cannot see. I smile, of course, and go on drinking tea. Right? The poem ends with a pathos, a pathetic statement, which reminds the reader that quite often many a footloose youth has had a precipitous fall and ruined himself in spite of having been gifted with the best talents. Right? So it is society, the elders of the society, the teachers who have handheld you, have shaped your intellect and your brains. When you came to the school, it was like a cloud of earth. They shaped it and sculpted it into a wonderful mind and set you on the path towards success. Right? Always be grateful. Be beholden to the society, to your teachers, to your parents, to all those people who have set an example before you. When you watch them, say, ah, here is a man, here is a woman, I would like to emulate, I would like to follow, right? Those are the people, they are the role models, and not the crooks and the morally bankrupt people who often find headlines in the newspapers and grab, you know, prime time on television, right? And many a youngster has been misled by this kind of false success, false stories of success that we often encounter in the press, in the media, in several other places, right? So be, although you must also have ambition. In English it is said, hitch your wagon at a star, right? Hitch your wagon at a star, aim at a star, so that even if you cannot reach the star, you will land on some other cosmic object, right? That's it. Always look up, look high, have great ambition, okay? But be always grounded, right? Your head should be in the clouds and your feet on clay, on the earth. Never lose that connection. And all of us, all of my peers have been insisted that be good human beings. I think that is what a school is supposed to do. That's the primary job of the school, to shape character. Because character is destiny. If character is lost, everything is lost. That's what they say, isn't it? If you have character, if there is grit and determination, and if there is perseverance, because perseverance is quite important. Hard work, it's not always destiny, it's not always luck, it's not always fortune that smiles upon you and you stumble upon a Nobel Prize. No, it's always hard work. Remember, it was Thomas Alva Edison, the man who holds hundreds of patents, the American discoverer, scientist, who said, success is 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration. So, don't take inspiration to be very important. Inspiration is important. But hard work, a lot of hard work is going in order to fructify that inspiration. These words, because I have already in the last session, I warned you all, don't give a microphone to a teacher. Because you go on speaking, so let me read and let me invite upon you the grace of the heavens, grace of God, grace of our society, your elders, your teachers, everybody, so that may you shine in life and be a beacon to others who will follow you. This school has added a lot of value, right? It's you who have added value to this school, but the school has added value to the surroundings. I'm told after this school was situated here, of course, it's a very big surrounding. For the first time I crossed the river and came to this part of the town, although I'm brought up in this town, in this city. It was a town, it was even a village. Right? That's it. The real estate value is gone. because of the school. Okay? And this school has done yeoman's job because it affords the opportunity for middle class parents, me, like your parents, to send them to a good institution where they can not only read and learn subjects well, but also be trained as good human beings, as I have seen today. Coming to a school is always a very nostalgic affair. I am reminded of my school days, my young days, and what I mean, what? You have done all those things. And look at the roses that you've given me. I have deliberately placed them in your direction so that you see roses. Look at this old man. Okay? Just listen to what I'm saying and let it register into your consciousness. With this fond hope that I have been able to tell you something of value, allow me to rest.
Dr. Tapan Patnaik, to speak few words, please.
Good evening, everybody. Esteemed Chairman, Sri Raghunathan, Manager and Mentor of the school, Sri Tapan Patnaik. Madam Principal Kanika Das, Vice Principal Sri Sarveshwar, eager and proud parents waiting outside and watching us live somewhere from the lounge, trustees of the school, illustrious students and their very illustrious teachers. First of all, I must express my gratitude for being allowed to sit and speak. Forgive me my doubts and my rheumatism. I cannot stand for a long time. So they have been generous, my peers have been generous enough to allow me to speak from the chair. So forgive me yet again. Now, young ladies and gentlemen, that's how I addressed your elders, your seniors, who were felicitated a while ago. And I have a very selfish intention in calling you young ladies and gentlemen, because that is what I expect you to become. I want you, I hope you understand the difference between a woman and a lady, right? A woman and a lady, a man and a gentleman, right? That's a strange language. English is a strange language, right? Very polite language. And it's so unlike our language that we often slip and fall. It's a very treacherous language also, right? So don't misunderstand me when I address you as ladies and gentlemen, because that is what I expect you to become. You have crossed a very important milestone of your lives with flying colors, and now you are well on your way to join the mainstream of civilian life in this country. And what have you? You have a certificate in hand that tells the world that you are inordinately intelligent and talented. Therefore, this society is full of expectations from you. Remember, every individual's life is entangled, inextricably entangled with this society. If the society collapses, where goes your brilliance? It comes to naught. It becomes meaningless, isn't it? And there are so many obstacles, impediments, allurements in life, in society particularly, isn't it? Particularly in our society. I'm sure half of you can recognize the photograph of Dawood Ibrahim, a criminal, right? We often hear names, say, Harshad Mehta, who swindled the country and its financial organizations, is hyped as some kind of a financial wizard, somebody who knew how to manipulate the money market, right? After he was accused and even convicted, he was invited by university economics departments, management departments to go and address. I think that's the wrong thing to do. Evil is always more attractive than good. Remember that. I'm reminded of the sentence. I'm almost tempted to quote a line from a very famous poet, modern poet. It's a modern poet. He says, "Youth is cruel and has no remorse." Remorse means repentance. "Youth is cruel and has no remorse and smiles at situations which it cannot see." I smile, of course, and go on drinking tea. Right? The poem ends with a pathos, a pathetic statement, which reminds the reader that quite often many a footloose youth has had a precipitous fall and ruined himself in spite of having been gifted with the best talents. Right? So it is society, the elders of the society, the teachers who have handheld you, have shaped your intellect and your brains. When you came to the school, it was like a cloud of earth. They shaped it and sculpted it into a wonderful mind and set you on the path towards success. Right? Always be grateful. Be beholden to the society, to your teachers, to your parents, to all those people who have set an example before you. When you watch them, say, "Ah, here is a man, here is a woman, I would like to emulate, I would like to follow," right? Those are the people, they are the role models, and not the crooks and the morally bankrupt people who often find headlines in the newspapers and grab, you know, prime time on television, right? And many a youngster has been misled by this kind of false success, false stories of success that we often encounter in the press, in the media, in several other places, right? So be, although you must also have ambition. In English it is said, hitch your wagon at a star, right? Hitch your wagon at a star, aim at a star, so that even if you cannot reach the star, you will land on some other cosmic object, right? That's it. Always look up, look high, have great ambition, okay? But be always grounded, right? Your head should be in the clouds and your feet on clay, on the earth. Never lose that connection. And all of us, all my peers have been saying that be good human beings. I think that is what a school is supposed to do. That's the primary job of the school, to shape character. Because character is destiny. If character is lost, everything is lost. That's what they say, isn't it? If you have character, if there is grit and determination, and if there is perseverance, because perseverance is quite important. Hard work, it's not always destiny, it's not always luck, it's not always fortune that smiles upon you and you stumble upon a Nobel Prize. No, it's always hard work. Remember, it was Thomas Alva Edison, the man who holds hundreds of patents, the American discoverer, scientist, who said, "Success is 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration." So, don't take inspiration to be very important. Inspiration is important, but hard work, a lot of hard work is going in order to fructify that inspiration. These words, because I have already in the last session, I warned you all, don't give a microphone to a teacher, because you go on speaking, so let me read and let me invite upon you the grace of the heavens, grace of God, grace of our society, your elders, your teachers, everybody, so that may you shine in life and be a beacon to others who will follow you. This school has added a lot of value, right? It's you who have added value to the school, but the school has added value to the surroundings. I'm told after the school was situated here, of course, it's a very easy surrounding. For the first time I crossed the river and came to this part of the town, although I'm brought up in this town, in this city. It was a town, it was even a village. Right, that's it. The real estate value has gone up because of the school. Okay, and this school has done yeoman's job because it affords the opportunity for middle class parents, me, like your parents, to send them to a good institution where they can not only read and learn their subjects well, but also be trained as good human beings. Today. Coming to a school is always a very nostalgic affair. I am reminded of my school days, my young days, and what have you? What? You have done all those things. And look at the roses that you've given me. I've deliberately placed them in your direction so that you see roses. Don't look at this old man. Okay? Listen to what I say and don't register in your consciousness. With this fond hope that I have been able to tell you something of value, allow me to rest.
I am totally proud of whatever you said. It was so heart-touching. Now moving further, I would request teachers Ms. Ananya Biswani to teach English and Ms. Vandana Pati to teach English to take over for the next segment of this program.
Thank you.
ಬರ್ತೀಯಾ?
Thank you.
achievers of 12 who have made entire DJ family truly proud.